everybody. It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the number one YouTube channel dedicated to 360 virtual reality filmmaking for everyone. As you all know, I bought the brand new GoPro Max, and while I'm still working on the official review video, going to be so in-depth and so amazing, by the way, so don't forget to subscribe. I want to focus on a quick tutorial series around the brand new GoPro FX Reframe plugin for Adobe Premiere and Adobe After Effects. Just to be clear, this is not a tutorial about the old GoPro VR Reframe plugin that released 4 years ago along with the GoPro Omni. 99.9% of the Reframe and overcapture tutorials on YouTube are based on the old plugin. I am very confident this tutorial will be the first one and hopefully the last one you need to learn how to create mind-blowing Reframe 2D video from 360 camera like the one you saw in this intro. Also, you don't need GoPro Max or Fusion to use the GoPro FX Reframe plugin in Premiere or After Effects. Any 360 footage from any camera will work, including the Insta360 ONE X, View XR, and the upcoming Kendall camera. Thank you again, GoPro, for being so generous on helping the community by releasing the plugin absolutely free. You have no excuse not to download it and try it yourself with whatever 360 camera you use. I will put the official link down below. If you own the GoPro Max and using the mobile app or even the Mac OS desktop app to do reframe and overcapture, I will also strongly suggest you to try the GoPro FX Reframe plugin. The reason is simple. The plugin is a lot more powerful and it has built-in realistic motion blur that will take your reframe animation to the next level, like what you saw in GoPro official commercial. And frankly, it is a lot faster compared to working with your fingers and your tiny phone screen, assuming you have a decent computer. Check out this tutorial on building your next level MacBook Pro for high productivity 360 productions. After you download and install the GoPro FX Reframe plugin, it will show under Video Effects, GoPro Effects. If you are not using GoPro Max camera, you can skip to this timecode. If you are using GoPro Max as your 360 camera, here is my workflow to generate the best lossless intermediate editing videos file. The goal here is to get the best image quality possible without any extra compression directly from the camera. And that is also why you should never use your mobile phone for editing and rendering, because GoPro iOS or Android app will compress your source video files to make it possible to edit directly on a phone, which is exactly not what you want. So you get your SD cards out of the camera, move all the files into your Mac or PC manually, then open the new GoPro player. If you have an eGPU, which is the best way to boost the performance of your old MacBook Pro, you can use it to speed up transcoding time by right-click on the GoPro player app and select Get Info and then check Prefer External GPU. Go ahead and open GoPro player. A window pops up and asks you to select files. Go to your Max footage folder and select the .260 file you want to render. In the current version of GoPro players, it does not have batch processing, so you need to render each video files one by one, manually. Well, here is a tip for you to save you some sleeping time. You can actually kind of queue up all the files in one go by clicking Shift and select all the .260 files and open them. It will open all the files and you can set them in queue one by one. So you can go to bed and wake up with all the beautiful footage. Well, hit the like button if I just save you some quality sleeping time. After opening your footage, you can go directly to File, Export As, 5.6K, toggle down arrow here to open up advanced options because Creator Up followers are advanced power user and we are awesome creating better content than those mobile phone users. Vibe check. Back to advanced options. Make sure you choose ProRes or Cineform if you're on a PC. Go ahead and hit next to render. Now it is the fun part. We are going to do some reframing. Open up Premiere because I'm afraid of After Effects. Create a 1080p or 4K sequence. 1080p is good for social media like Facebook, YouTube. In 2020, you should really do 4K. Good news is GoPro FX Reframe can handle all that and more. Drop in the newly rendered 360 video files. If you are rendering ProRes as I suggested in the earlier step, you should not need proxy. But if you are importing footage from installed 360 1X camera, I will suggest creating a proxy, a ProRes proxy, following this tutorial. Click Keep Sequence Setting to keep 1080p or 4K timeline. Here we have a drone footage captured with the GoPro Max. Go ahead, drop in the new GoPro FX Reframe. For good practices, I saved the GoPro FX Reframe in my favorite effects folders, so I don't need to search it every time. Here, I will drop the resolution into 1.4 as I am not using proxy and I am doing a screen capture at the same time. Go ahead and open Effect Control. Make the area a little bit bigger so you can see what's going on. Before we start, toggle Open Advanced Control to uncheck Motion Blur. This will increase the preview speed. Step 1 is to pick Projection. I choose GoPro HD because this is a 1080p sequence. If you are doing Instagram posts, you can choose the Social 1x1 or Social 4x5. For the best Instagram post format is actually Social 4x5. For an Instagram story or IGTV, you can choose the 9x16 vertical format. By the way, if you need Tiny Planet photo or video inspiration, please follow me on the gram here at hugh.hou, where you will learn the latest technique behind the scenes on 360 filmmaking. Next, we are going to reframe our first frame. Before touching the pen, tilt or rotate, click the pen and make sure the pen is highlighted in the Effect Control panel. You see an overlay on the Premiere program window. If you cannot see it, let me pan it up to the blue sky and now you should be able to see it. Next, click and drag to your first location. You see you are moving the pen and tilt while you are doing that. The rotation is usually easier to just dial in the number here. Thanks to GoPro Max new stabilization feature, my drone shot horizon line is already level without me rotating anything. So we are just gonna keep the rotation in zero position. Insert a keyframe on all the values. The lens curve is a new value compared to the old GoPro VR reframe plugin. It allows you to fix fisheye distortion easily and you can animate it to create very interesting effects, which we will cover it in the next tutorial. Leave the zoom in 100 and we will zoom out in the next keyframe. So now I want to create a tiny planet transition, which is a very popular edit in most of my Instagram videos and the intro of you just saw in this video. To create a tiny planet reframe, go ahead and find the location you want in the timeline, insert all the keyframes, change the value of the tilt to minus 90 degrees, and the center of the frame is pointing at the center of the 360 videos or the tripod leg. If you want to create an inverted tiny planet, you can change the value of the tilt to positive 90 degrees. As you see now, you are positioning pointing to the sky, and the sky will be in the middle of your frame. For other creative reframe techniques, I will highly recommend you to check out this video where I show you 50 reframe techniques commonly used in 360 videos. I assume you already watched that video, so I am moving on. Then you reset your lens curve adjustment down to 0 and reduce the zoom level to 30. You get yourself a tiny planet in video. Cell 5 and virtual high five. Well, now is the cool part that only the GoPro FX Reframe plugin can do. Motion blur. Toggle open advanced control, check the motion blur and preview your animation. Click sequence and render in and out points to see the final result. It is a little bit too slow in my taste, so I make the keyframe shorter. I also added 180 degrees rotation so the planet will spin when it morphs. Now you see the motion blur. Look really cinematic, right? So if you want more motion blur, go ahead and increase the shutter angle to higher value and you will see more motion blur. Bonus tip, you can add a second camera by clicking enable second camera. Now instead of one, you can create two tiny planet or front and back view for vlogging. This is extremely powerful. As you see here, I create a front view of where I'm running to and a circle view of my face from the back lens. So I can vlog and user can see both my face and where I'm looking at. Very cool, huh?
Plug-in error in Windows and how to solve it. At the time of recording, some of the Windows users, including myself, running into plug-in error in Adobe Premiere when applying GoPro FX Reframe, as you see right here. This is actually a plug-in conflict. According to David Newman from GoPro, the error is caused by a graphic library, GLFW. If you have installed 360 camera, including the 1X, Evo, or the Pro 2, highly likely you have the issues. The solution is simple. Go to this path in Windows, I provide the path in the description below, then remove all the installed 360 importer plugins in Media Core folders. Restart Premiere and try it again, it should work in PC now. As you see right here, it is working for me and I can create Tiny Planet using the exact workflow in my Mac. I hope this helped others having the same issue.
In the next video, the part 2 of this tutorial, I will go a little more practical to show you how I create this very cool upside down teleportation transition using the GoPro FX Reframe plugin right here in Adobe Premiere. I will also show you color grading techniques on GoPro Max and sound design techniques to make your footage look cinematic so your video will stand out from the crowd. Look professional and wow your audience. I can't wait to see you next time because the next tutorial is really cool. You will apply everything you learned today in practice and create something might just break the internet. Hit the subscribe button if you have not and give me a thumb up and share this video on your social media. It will really help me to create more amazing content for you instead of working my ass off as a professional 360 videographer, which is also fun, and how I have real skills to teach you. Until next time, stay creative. Thank you.